Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. A really interesting matchup of coaches in this game. One guy sort of subscribes to the old school philosophy. It's been ingrained in him from his time as a player. You keep the ball on the ground, you win with toughness, and you follow the rules that have always won football games. The guy on the other sideline, he doesn't believe that. He's pitched out the old book and he's riding his new one. Both of them have been very effective so far. We'll see which one comes out on top today. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Built in 1962, the site for this college football contest. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Bates is lined up and just about ready to send this one off as we're ready to get this game underway.
Larson
takes it from the six. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. The Falcons' offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 29. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. Fires it out. Tackle made at the 44.
This is a quarterback who trusts his receivers, and he knows they can make plays. It's like those two were playing catch out there.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. Pitches, and he's got room. He gets out to about the 44-yard line. So the option play gets him big yards right there.
Yeah, you know, it's amazing how sometimes this guy is able to find a hole and get through.
He's tackled around the 42-yard line.
That makes it
second
and eight.
It's second down and eight. Ball on the 42-yard line. They give it to him again, and he's going to lose yardage. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
Sailed on it.
He wanted his receiver, but I think that may have slipped out of his hands.
That'll bring up fourth and nine.
Chance is back deep to return. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. slings it out, and it gets tipped.
That's the kind of field vision you want out of your linebackers. They have to play well in coverage, and they have to be able to break up pass plays.
Second and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gaining 4 yards. That'll bring up third and 6.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he's taken down at the 34.
Gain of 10 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
From their own 34-yard line, first down. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a 5-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. And he's tackled at the 50. Madison's the kind of guy that could end up with some national honors because right now he's leading the conference statistically. So it's second and 13. Ball on the 47. Caught out of the open. He's taken down at the 46.
Gain of 7 on the play. Third down.
The sub package in there defensively in this 5-wide receiver set. He scrambled, runs with it, and he's got room. And down he goes at the 31-yard line.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Takes a handoff, tackled for a loss. Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 33. Quick pass. Brought down in the open field.
That'll bring up third and 8.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Gets it. He's in space. And they make the stop right around the 16-yard line. We've played one. Now this one's scoreless. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2. And they're going to put 6 DBs on the field to counter that 5 receiver look. Caught with room to work. The 5. Touchdown, Western Kentucky. He splits the uprights with the extra point. An 11-play, 80-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Larson from the 2. And down he goes at the 26. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Get that hand with us. Black 5.
fights forward to about the 29.
Gain of three on the play. That makes it second and eight.
Second and eight coming up here. Ball on their own 29. Now he pitches it. Good outside run there.
Decision, if you ask me. They're lucky it didn't go for a loss.
From their own 38-yard line, first down. Tackle at about the 49. First and 10, ball on the 34. Got some open field. A gain of eight on the carry.
That makes it second and two.
Makes it out to about the 10.
I like how efficient the offense looks on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
This is the eighth play of this drive.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
That brings up second and 13.
From the 13-yard line, second down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Here's play number 10 on the drive. This should be an easy field goal. Kicks up. And they tack on 3 points.
Even though they gave up the field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
They line up to kick this one away. Chance from the 7. And he's taken down at the 21-yard line. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Western Kentucky is up by 4. And here's a quick throw. And this one's broken up.
When you play the quarterback position, you have to be able to read the defense and look off defenders. He didn't really do that on that pass. He was lucky it was only a tip and not a pick.
From their own 21-yard line, it's second down.
passes into the receiver on the play. That brings us third and 10.
Wants it all. Going deep. He's hit and taken down.
First down.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. He's at the 30, and he hauls that one in. Tackle made at the 11. So on first down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked a perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
The Hilltoppers call a timeout. That's their second of the half.
That was just smash-mouth, helmet-to-chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 12. Finds his receiver. Touchdown. Catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And he converts the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
We keep your finger on the pulse of the top 10. And for Virginia Tech, stubbornly keeping it on the ground and scoring a touchdown. And for Russell, he's found pay dirt twice on the day. Notre Dame has the edge 24-7.
And Reese Davis back to the action here. Bates has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. It's fielded at the 2. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Just about ready to call the first play of this drive. They were able to pick up a field goal on their last possession. Makes it out to about the 30. He really showed some good speed there.
I'll tell you, no question. When you talk about being able to turn on the jets and leave everybody in the dust, you have to mention this young man. He's got skills, but his speed is what the pro scouts are drooling about.
He's tackled around the 34-yard line. 4 yards there on the scramble. From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. Throws it deep. Missed him.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
He's scrambling. The Hilltoppers using their third and last timeout. Johnson picks up about 4 yards after pulling the ball down and scrambling there. Rollins is the punter. Didn't get all of that one. He drops it. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here. He's on the run. And he dives forward.
Well, this is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
Tackle.
scrambling. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
He makes the PAT. Air Force gets set to kick this one away. And he's tackled at the 29. So the offense comes out after their last drive, had the ball end up in the defense's hands by way of a fumble.
You don't change your philosophy after one play. They'll be out doing the same thing as before, just with better awareness.
Western Kentucky holds a four-point lead. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. I guess he'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. He lets it fly. Almost picked off. Game in the works, folks, as we come to the end of the first half. 14-10, Hilltopper.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Take a look at both quarterbacks in this game, and neither one of them even has their pants dirty. Nobody's been on the ground here. No pressure generated by the defense, but one of the reasons is because quarterbacks have been able to get rid of the football. Maybe a little help in the secondary to those guys trying to rush the pass.
The guys up front always get the blame, but it really is a business that works hand in hand, because you can get a lot of sacks off garbage sacks where it's great coverage down the field, but the quarterback has to hold it for 4 or 5 seconds. But it works the other way around too. If somebody's open every time he pats that football and reaches the top of his drop, I can't get there in time. So the coverage needs to tighten up a little bit, mess up the rhythm, jam the receivers maybe a little bit more. Give me a little bit of time so those big boys up front can get to the quarterback.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. The offense is coming out on the field, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone lately. Western Kentucky is up 4. Up the middle for a nice gain.
That makes it 7-6.
It's second down, 6 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Over the middle, got his tight end. He's still going. And down he goes at the 16.
Davis makes the tackle at the 16-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play.
Three down.
Offense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Throws it out, and it falls incomplete. From the 16-yard line, it's third down. He delivers, throws, and he's got a man. Touchdown. And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And he tacks on the extra point. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
Let's take a look at scores around the country. This one's been entertaining us all day long. The Fighting Irish have the edge, 27-7.
All right, thanks, Reese. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He's to the 40. Inside the 30. Touchdown, Air Force. Hits the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 34. Both these offenses stepping up and answering the bell. Who's going to blink first here?
Exactly right. I've just been impressed with the way they've been able to execute. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on them. Anytime you're feeling that the other offense can put points up on the board, there's a tendency to want to press. Neither one has done that up to this point, and right now it's going to come down to who can continue to execute and put points up.
The offense is on its way out on the field again, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone in their past couple of drives.
So much of the passing game is about timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
Well-designed route and a confidently thrown football by the quarterback. You need those things to make any offense work.
Western Kentucky is up by 4. Under pressure. Quick out to his receiver. And he's tackled at the 45-yard line.
Number 54 makes the tackle. First down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45. Here they come, and he's sacked.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding a rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 46-yard line. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Makes the grab, and he's got the first.
Sanders on the tackle with the
33-yard line. First down.
Right, right, right. Two down, two down. Mike 55, Mike 55. Eat, 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 eat.
Run, left side. They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. Second and nine. Ball on the 32-yard line. Gets it out in a hurry. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. They come out in a five-wide set. He's level at the 40-yard line. The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Western Kentucky holds a four-point lead. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Tackle at the 33. From their own 33-yard line. First down. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's another rush from this halfback. This time he does a great job of finding the opening in the defense and picking up a first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. And they make the stop around the 43-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
40, to the 20, the 10. First and goal coming up. He's knocked out after a big game. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. They've got their goal line sets on the field. This might be a good time for play action. He's taken down at the 5-yard line.
That brings him second and goal.
So at the end of the third quarter, Western Kentucky leads 21-17. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Yard line.
That's a loss of 3 yards on the line. That makes it third and goal.
So here it is, crucial third down as they try to take the lead. He's going to try and scramble. Room around the corner. He's in. Touchdown. And they take the lead.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point.
He splits the uprights with the extra point.
An eight-play, 81-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
Chance from the eight. He's tackled at the 27.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Gets out to around the 38.
First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Makes it to the 47.
They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9.
That brings up second and one.
Taken down at midfield.
Gain of 3 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
From the 50, it's first down.
Brought down at the 49.
To about the 48-yard line. Third down and long, and they could really use the big play by their here this late in the game. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Quick throw incomplete, one of his receivers.
Jenkins was the intended receiver on that play. That makes it fourth and 8.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Caught, and this is going to be a first down. He's tackled right around the 36-yard line.
First down.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Fires complete over the middle. And down he goes at the 18-yard line.
First down.
From the 18-yard line. First down. Completely stopped immediately.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
This is the 10th play of this drive. On the ground, he won't get back to the line. From the 14-yard line, third down.
Zips it to the back. Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close.
He gets it up, and he got it. Western Kentucky, the kick. He'll return it from the one. And down he goes at the 28.
Air Force's game plan couldn't have imagined things to go this well. They've scored 24 points in a row. Here we are late in the fourth quarter, and this is what this game has come down to. Every possession's going to count, and this could be the one right here.
Under a minute left in the game. Quick strike to the receiver.
To his receiver. He's pushed out of bounds at the 46.
And that's the end of the fourth quarter, and we're going to take this deadlock into overtime.
Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime.
He shoved out of bounds at the 23.
Gain two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
From the 23-yard line, second down. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 13.
Breaks the tackle and he'll score. Touchdown.
Well, that's how you want to start off an overtime period, to put the touchdown on the board and put the pressure now on them. They know they've got to match this touchdown if they want to stay alive.
Converts the extra point. From the 25-yard line, first down. This one's going deep to the end zone. This one will fall incomplete. There's a very impressive open field tackle. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. He gets out to about the 12-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. First down.
He laterals. He tackles him for a loss.
Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 13-yard line. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. To the receiver, incomplete. So they'll get one last stab at tying this up. Throws incomplete. Final, a close one to the very end. Air Force 31, Western Kentucky 24. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.